A few moments later.
Hey guys. Welcome back to Sgcarmart Reviews. And today, I feel like I'm on holiday because I feel like I have a lot of freedom. The freedom to what? The freedom to power my dreams. And the car that we're looking at today is none other than the Honda Freed second generation facelift 1.5. Now let's find out more about this freedom machine. Now, before we have the freedom to find out more about this car, if you're thinking about buying a car like this Honda Freed 1.5 and thinking about trading in your car, try selling it with Quotz instead. Quotz helps you sell your car quickly and easily. With the new Quotz doorstep, get a professional inspection by our certified mechanics at your convenience anywhere on the island. Quotz will then auction out your car online to its wide network of dealers to bid on your car. Once bidding is complete, Quotz will update you with the best offer price at no obligation. It's that easy. To find out more, visit quotz.com.sg. That's quotz.com.sg. Now we have the freedom to find out more about this Freed. Now this is of course Honda's smallest MPV, built for the needs of 6 or maybe 7 people, but in a compact little package. This is also built on the Fit or Jazz platform. Now this being the second generation facelift, it doesn't look too different. So one look, even if you've never seen this before, you can tell it's probably a Honda Freed. In the front, you're going to get a new blacked out honey chrome grille, as well as more body color portions at the bottom, as well as a front splitter. You're going to get LED lights, but not the full treatment. As you can see, some bulbs here are actually still halogen. Now onto the sides. Now for the car motor's version of the Honda Freed, you're going to find two trims, the lower S7 trim as well as the higher E7 trim. Though, on both trims, you're going to find 15-inch rims and disc brakes in front and drum brakes in the rear. You're also going to get keyless entry as well as a power sliding door that you'll see in B-roll right about now. Now onto the back, you're going to get a tiny little fuel cap right here, which holds 36 litres inside this car. And now, let's check out the rear.
The Honda Freed is priced from $72,000 to $75,000 without COE. The 1.5-litre engine produces 129 brake horsepower and 155 Nm of torque. The CVT transmission brings the car from 0 to 100 km per hour in 13 seconds. The car has a claimed fuel consumption of 16.9 km per litre. For more details on the Honda Freed or any other car, head on to sgcarmart.com to help you make the smart choice on your next car.
Now over by the rear, in case I haven't mentioned, this colour is Fjord Mist Pearl. Fjord Mist Pearl. I don't know what that means, but I really like this colour. If you ask me, it's more of a baby blue, and I think it's a really, really cute colour that I would like on my car. Now you're going to find your antenna at the side. It's not kind of not symmetrical. I like it symmetrical, but it's fine. You're going to get a high mount stop brake light here. You're going to get a rear wiper. Because it is an MPV, sedans can usually use the wind to push the water off. And of course, signature Honda Freed devil horn brake lights. Now, when you step on it, it's going to light up like this and look like, I always see on the road, like devil horns, little devils. Now you're going to get your Freed moniker here. Open up the manual tailgate to, I gotta preface this, the seats are all up, so you can actually sit 7 here and still hold stuff in the rear. But you gotta be careful because our anti-trolley is right here. It's empty, but normally if you have stuff inside, it's gonna weigh it down. But because it's empty, it's kind of might do this. But I think it's mighty impressive for an MPV of this size to still hold the trolley. You might have to be careful because the anti-trolley didn't fall, but that's because this is empty. I think with groceries inside, it's gonna stand by itself. But what I think is mighty impressive is a Cat A MPV that can seat 7, all the seats fully up, and still hold a luggage as well as an anti-trolley in place. Now the third row seats are pretty solid, but if you need a ton more space in the rear, you can fold down the rear seats as such. This latch on the side, pull on this tab and lift it up so it folds up kind of like inside an Alpha, and then you push this chair stand down so it's a lot more space. You can sit here and have a lot more luggage as well. Now if you really do need to, you can fold down the second row seats as well, but now let's check out the third row seats. Now from the side, from the power doors, to access the third row, you lift up this latch and the chairs will fold down as such, and then you can climb into the third row two seats. And it is gonna be quite a bit of a squeeze, and as you can see with the third row down, I am pretty much floor to knee to chair behind, so at least there's still some head space for me, a 1.75 meters tall person. In terms of amenities, you're gonna find not much. You're gonna find a little armrest here, as well as a cup holder on either side, and a grab bar to make things easier. Now, if you wanna exit the third row and check out the second row, like I am gonna do, pull on this, and the chairs will fold up, and revealing, of course, a tire repair kit as well. Now, in the second row, you're gonna be a lot more comfortable. I am 1.75 meters tall. This is my head space. This is my leg space. There's plenty of room down here for me to tuck my feet under the driver's seat. But if you need more space for your cargo behind, you can actually lift this lever and lift the seats forward. And because the way these folding seats are designed, you can actually set them to recline all the way like this. So for your rear passengers, they're gonna be very, very comfortable. In terms of amenities, you're not gonna get a dome light here. It's somewhere more in front. And at the side, you're gonna get privacy screens, but only for the higher E7 trim and not for the lower S7 trim. Now, I really, really like this because it can act as a sunshade. And nowadays, when you buy cars, usually the first thing you buy is a magnetic sunshade, and this comes inbuilt. So, good for privacy, good for keeping the heat out. And you're also gonna get your door control, your window control, and a little magazine holder up here, which I think is nice. It doesn't have to be like true magazine holders of the past, like airplanes or cars. Doesn't be down here, it can be up here. Now, in terms of other amenities, you're not gonna find a middle row aircon, but that's because there's so much space inside the center and you can kind of feel the aircon coming through from the front. You're also not gonna get any USB charging for the middle passengers. Now, you can pull out this little armrest, but it's probably not the sturdiest. Now you're gonna find ISOFIX points here, 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 and here, as well as seat belts, so that for the rear, for the middle passenger, that can seat a sling across the chest. Now let's check out the front. Now what Honda has done well for this MPV of this category is that there are plenty and plenty of storage spaces right here inside the cockpit. So I have a cup holder here, little cubby space here, cup holder here. You're not gonna get your center console one because it is a clear aisle. So I guess you can move to the back easily. Otherwise, a hideaway cup holder, a hideaway tray, as well as a little compartment here, and of course this underneath the dashboard, and at the sides as well for both the driver and the front passenger. You're gonna get plenty of compartments all here. Now in the front, you're gonna get your instruments inside this little slit up front, and LCD displays, which I think they look pretty good, which is what I like. It doesn't have to be expensive, but it's done well. However, for your steering wheel, it is gonna be quite sparse. You're only gonna get your media controls, as well as cruise control, which isn't the adaptive cruise control. This is just your basic cruise control. This really reminds me of the steering wheel inside the Jazz, GK generation Jazz, which is one generation before the one that they're using for the EHEV right now. Now, apart from that, the finish on the inside is done rather well with this really nice wood trimming, so it gives you a cozier feel. However, your buttons, like your hazard lights, are up here and just a simple plastic. Now, the infotainment system is a bit of an oddity. I thought that they would have imported the same one that they've used inside the new Jazz EHEV, as well as the new Civic, which looks a lot more refined and a nicer, wider screen. However, they've went with this Alpine brand. Other than that, down here on your gear shift, it's going to be very simple plastic. Two buttons for engine auto start stop to turn off, as well as econ mode while driving. And here it is, your single zone climate control, which, to be honest, it looks pretty nice. It is a very nice dial, nice buttons to touch, and a very nice LCD display here. And lastly, on top, you're gonna find one mirror for your rear view with your rear dimming as such at night. And more importantly, a secondary mirror so you can look at your passengers at the rear. So this is really helpful for young parents with young kids that they need to look out for. By the center, you're gonna get a USB-A. Now this connects to Android Auto or Apple CarPlay, and a 12 volt charger right here. Now that's about it for this car, but does it drive as well as it looks? Only one way to find out. So, driving the Honda Freed out on the road, how does it feel like? Well, it feels extremely familiar. It feels like a Honda. This brings me back to the days of my Honda Jazz ownership. That was my first car, the GK Jazz 1.3, and this feels exactly like that, with just a slightly bigger power plant. Talking about power plant, this is powered by a 1.5 litre naturally aspirated engine mated to a continuously variable transmission, which is very Honda. They've been doing that for the Jazz, they're doing that for the Civic, and in terms of stepping on a pedal, fueling the pull of the car, it feels exactly the same. Like, this is a Honda Honda. Now the instrument cluster up there, I like it. It's really legible. I like that it's not a super expensive, fully digital LED display. It's a good old LCD and it's really, really easy to see. And I've liked that they've taken the effort to a little bit go and shade off the little bars up top so it looks very nicely done. It doesn't have to be simple, but it's well done and I really like it. And when I step on the pedal, just like inside the Jazz, there's a little bit of a color indicator to let me know that whether or not I'm driving in the most eco-friendly or the most fuel consumption friendly way. So right now it's green as I'm coasting, and if I want to pump the beans a little bit, it goes orange, so it's really easy to see, really easy to tell how I'm driving. One glance on the road, I can see it in my periphery. Very useful. Now in terms of safety, inside this Honda Freed, you're gonna get two SRS airbags up front and a rear view monitor for parking, as well as rear parking sensors. And that's about it. You're also gonna get standard cruise control, so it is not adaptive cruise control. The Honda Freed is really comfortable. They've adapted the suspension to be really well damped, so it goes over hard bumps really well. Like, I was surprised by this level of comfort. It is a little bit floaty right now, but it's not too like rocky back and forth. And I also believe it because right now we only have me and two other producers inside the car, so it's a load of three people when this car is technically built for purpose of seven people, so maybe 5 to 6 people plus some stuff in the rear. It is very, it rides like a cloud. That's what I can say about the comfort of this car. In terms of NVH, it's gonna be not too bad. You can hear a little bit of a noise on the road coming in, permeating from the other cars, like the truck we just passed. It's not unbearable, but it's also not super amazing. So the Honda Freed 1.5, is this a will buy, won't buy, or go try? Well, this Honda Freed is a go try. Why? Because I think it brings a very interesting proposition to the table. If you're looking for a 7-seater Cat A MPV, this is an option. It brings another option to the table. Of course, elephant in the room, or rather MPV in the room, it's going to be competing against the Toyota Sienta Hybrid. And this, in some ways, will hold up its own, but at least that's good to have another option. So that's it, that's our review of the Honda Freed 1.5. What do you think? Do you agree with us or do you disagree with us? Let us know down in the comments below. As well as any other car that you'd like to see us try out, do leave it in the comments and we'll read every single one of these. Now, if you've made it this far, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel, as well as hit the bell notification icon so you don't miss any of our future uploads. And follow us on TikTok, we are at Sgcarmart. Thanks for watching. I'll see you on the next one. Bye-bye. And subscribe to this video and by hitting the... Forget to like and subscribe to our channel by hitting... Get notified of every single upload that we make. So, TikTok, we are at Sgcarmart for the latest updates. For the latest updates that we do on TikTok. I'm so... Don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel. We are every single one of these. Now, don't.